The Niagara Frontier winter tradition, the Festival of Lights, launches its seventh season, and it includes attractions aimed at pleasing everybody and drawing them to the Niagara Falls, New York area. Our man Mike Randall is high on one of the festival's features.
I had heard that there was something up here in the Greek Theater at the Niagara Falls Convention Center. And you know what? There was. Peter Pan was taking a few practice flights in preparation for his upcoming performance.
It's great. It's lots of fun. I wish I could do it all day.
There's got to be some trick to this flying thing.
You just think lovely, wonderful thoughts, and up you go!
It was plain to see we weren't going to get many answers out of Peter Pan. What we can tell you is that Peter Pan is a wonderful show that combines music, dance, and flying. The flying is accomplished with an expensive and complicated system of wires and pulleys. The end result is it provides the audience with a terrific illusion and the director with a lot of headaches.
Kind of made me nervous at the beginning because you have to find a way for the actors to sing and dance and float above the audience's heads. That's kind of a big task.
It's a task that director Fran Newton accomplished by getting the same company involved that flew Mary Martin and Superman. But whenever someone is flying 15 feet off the ground, there is still an element of danger.
We have everything just checked and double-checked about five times to make sure that there is no problems. And I feel very comfortable with it, and all the actors feel very comfortable with it at this point.
Peter Pan will be coming in for a landing for six performances beginning November 27th. You can contact the Niagara Falls Convention Center if you'd like to get in on the fun.
Why should Peter Pan have all the fun, eh?
Hanging around the Niagara Falls Convention Center, this is Mike Randall for Eyewitness News.